Hey there, welcome back to Manotick StringWorks. Glad to have you here. So please remember to like and subscribe for more videos. So today on the bench, we've got a Morgan Acoustic, an OM Series made in Vancouver, Canada. So let's have a look at this guitar. Really nice, very pretty. It has been well used. So that's a good thing. I like that. I like guitars to have a history. And you can see a few scratches and dents. There's the label, Vancouver, Canada. Nice mother of pearl inlay there around the sound hole. There's the headstock logo. That's nice as well. Good size guitar, a little smaller than a dreadnought. You can see some more of the wear, some hard strumming. See if I can get the light. There we go. So picking this guitar up, I could hear something inside. Wasn't sure if it was just a loose wire from the battery compartment to the EQ. Anyways, once I get the strings off, I'll have a look in there. All right, we'll start off by checking the neck relief. And it's pretty good. It's right around 12 thousandths, a little less. And we'll start with the 5 and 6/64 string height gauge. Pretty sure it's around 6, maybe a little higher. Measure that at the 12th fret. So let's get these strings off. Clean up the guitar. We'll check out what that rattling noise is inside the sound hole in the body. Clean, polish the frets a little bit. I usually like to put a cloth of some sort right down on the soundboard. Now this guitar has a lot of wear, so probably wouldn't notice an extra ding or two, but or scuff, but still. Good practice. So let's have a peek inside there, see what we can find. I think you can just sort of catch a glimpse of it in the mirror. There it is. It's looks like an old string. There's the ball end of an old string. So I have these long needle nose pliers. I reach in there. I'm trying to shake it around a bit, but oh, here we go. Even comes with its own dust bunny. Nice. I was talking to the client after. I thought he was trying to fish something through or whatever, but I think it was just cut off and fell in. I was checking the battery compartment. It's just a Velcro, little neoprene sort of case. So I'll just make sure it's attached while my hand's in there. Just wanted to see where the truss rod nut is. That's in a pretty difficult location, stuck under some bracing there. Not sure what I'm looking for there. We'll leave that in, though. So here's a big crack in the soundboard. Runs with the grain. That's pretty common. We'll have another look at that a little closer. Doesn't affect the playability of the guitar. It wasn't ringing or making funny noises. But you want to make sure the guitar doesn't fall apart in the future, right? So get my mirror out again. It's got a little light on it. What I'm going to try and do is put the mirror in there with the light, turn the shop lights off, and see if, you know, that crack is just through the finish or it's actually through the whole soundboard. So we'll see if that works. Yeah, so I'll have to turn all the shop lights off. There we go. So I wasn't sure how this would work with the camera, but you can see the lights under there. So I could see it a little better in real life. So hopefully this shows you just that line right there. And you can sort of see, you can see the light coming through. So there is a crack in the soundboard. Again, it's not affecting the playability, but I think after this summer, you know, the humidity we have, we'll check it again. All right, again, you know, good amount of wear on the fretboard. Frets aren't too bad. You know, the first, second, third frets do have some fret wear. But certainly not horrible. I think cleaning them up with the fret eraser and that might get rid of most of that. All right, give the soundboard, the fretboard a quick cleaning with your safe, environmentally friendly cleaner of your choice. Always good to get the grime off. You can use that cleaner all over the guitar too. And I'll just use the fret eraser. So four grits, 150, 180, 400, and 1,000. And again, it gives the frets a good cleaning and a light polishing. This should take out a lot of those dents in the frets, too. And I decided to use some 4-0 steel wool as well. Use the fretboard protector there and just give them a little running over. Does smooth them out nicely. Hard on the fingers, though. All right, a little Dunlop 65 on the fretboard. I'll put some on the bridge as well, since it's rosewood. Yeah, not too much, just enough to hydrate the wood. And you do this a couple of times a year. Not every string change, but I would do it at least twice a year. All right, so we'll start putting the strings through. So, you know, every guitar is a little different. Tuning post height, that kind of stuff, length of the guitar. So try it a couple of times. So in this guitar, you know, sort of one tuning post, about an inch and a half past the tuning post seemed to work well with the wound strings. Again, just make sure the wrappings go underneath the string you pull through the post hole. That creates that tension. There we go, they're all done. So I'll leave them a little long for now, in case I have to pull one through for some reason. A little easier to grab. So the next step is to tune up all the strings and stretch them. So I do this usually two or three times. And generally, this is when I let the guitar sit overnight, like, and then check it again the next day. Once it's got, so it's tuned to pitch and at the correct tension. So here we are, next day. So it's sat overnight. So I'm going to tune her up. So this client liked his guitar tuned down a half step. So that's why I've done the setup in that tuning. So we'll check the relief. It was right around just under 12 thousandths. Didn't move. So that's good. So if the feeler gauge is scraping it, that means it's a little less, right, than the gauge. So, and again, right around 20 thousandths, 18 to 20 thousandths at the first fret. So that's pretty good. This was a little low, this one, but really can't cut the nut down, you know, any further. You don't want to do that. But there's no buzzing in the open strings, so everything's nice. Nice low action up there. And we'll check the string height at the 12th fret. And in this case, it was about a little higher than 6, about 6.5, maybe 7 on the low E, and then it was 6/64 at the first string. So, very acceptable for acoustic guitar. And really, the bridge was very low. I mean, the action might have already been lowered once, so I don't really know that you could just sand down the saddle. So just checking the intonation quickly here. The tuner's off camera, but it's pretty good. Again, with new strings, it takes a little while for everything to settle a bit. All right, well, a little cleanup, string change. We'll clip these down so I don't stab myself or anyone else. Tidies it up nicely. Make sure you get them right down to the tuning post, eh, so they're not sticking up, especially those plain strings. I just noticed that one of the nuts around the tuning post was just a little bit loose, so I just decided to check them all. They're all pretty tight, just the one. So that's good. All right, well, that's it. So thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please like and subscribe for more video content. I do enjoy making them. It's a lot of fun. Hope you enjoy them. We'll see you next time. Stay safe. Stay healthy. Bye for now.